Hello everyone, this is Kyle Malone from alacartgp.com. Welcome. Today we're going to talk about the Payables credit card setup and processing within Dynamics GP 2018. Most of what you see today will apply to pretty much every GP version in existence that I think most people are using, at least hopefully. But there are some new features pertaining to credit cards with 2018 that we will definitely touch on today. The credit card process in GP, once you get it set up, I think it's pretty straightforward, but there are a couple hidden setup options and a couple things that are nice to know before you get in there and start setting things up. Save you a lot of time. So without further ado, we'll go ahead and dive right in. Here we go. All right, so here we are. I'm in 2018 of Dynamics GP. The credit card setup actually goes under the Administration tab, under the Setup, under Company, and under Credit Cards. So of course we got to set up our credit cards before we can start processing with credit cards in the system. So here's my credit card window. I'm actually going to select a card that I've already set up here. I have one out here called Kyle Visa Chase. The reason I have that up is you have a couple different options when you're setting up credit cards. I could set up just one credit card. So say I have I could just set up one credit card in the system and basically denote with the vouchers that I'm going to process. So for Amazon, for example, I can just denote that I pay this invoice with a credit card. I can also go a step further and I could say I pay this invoice with Kyle's Visa Chase credit card. So that's why I added a little bit of additional detail in the card name there, and we'll kind of take a look at that as we get through this process. So when you are setting up a credit card here, you have two different options for starters. Accepted by customers, used by company. So there is the ability to set up credit cards in the system for receiving customer payments. We're not going to talk about that today. We're just going to talk about using credit cards for purchasing. So I'm going to select the used by company. And then you'll notice after I select the used by company, I have two different options here. One is credit card, one is check card. The credit card option here, you'll notice that it makes the vendor ID option available. What this essentially does is when I pay Amazon in the system, it is going to say, okay, I just paid Amazon, but I paid it with my Chase. This is actually my Chase vendor. I paid it with my Chase credit card. So it pays Amazon and then it creates a subsequent voucher to Chase. So that way I can turn around at the end of this process and cut my payment to Chase for my entire credit card statement. And then your other option here is a check card. And the check card option, that's where you actually just set it up and basically every transaction that you process goes to a checkbook. So as I pay Amazon in the system, I basically am taking a amount out of a certain checkbook that I have set up for my credit cards. And that's kind of denoting that I've made the payment to Chase. When you actually make the payment to Chase, you can do a bank transaction, you can do a manual payment, but it doesn't go through the payables module at that time. So I prefer the credit card setup with the vendor being Chase, that's the person I'm going to pay in the end. All right, so enough talking about that. So I have my credit card set up, Kyle Visa Chase. So let's go to our purchasing module here, transactions. We're gonna go ahead and process a voucher. So I keep saying Amazon, we'll go with that. So I have a computer purchase here and my vendor is Amazon. Invoice number, whatever might that be. And then my computer is for $1,000. So typically when I'm processing a voucher in the system, that's it. Well, you probably are aware that there is a field here called credit card. So I'm actually going to say that I paid this entire invoice with a credit card. And when I tab out, I'm prompted with the credit card information. You guessed it. I'm going to go out here and select my Kyle Visa credit card. If I had additional information of, you know, when I made that credit card payment, or maybe what the statement number was. If I'm looking at my statement, I can add that additional information here. We're gonna go ahead and select OK. And we'll take a quick look at the distributions because they are interesting here. So of course I have my expense. You'll see my type is a cash. And that doesn't really make a whole lot of sense, but there's not an option here that says credit card. So it just gives you cash by default. But notice that it is going to the accounts payable. This accounts payable account is actually pulling from the Chase Bank vendor that we have set up. So kind of an important note, if you were to get in this without knowing that, you might spend some time figuring out why you can't find your correct distributions. So the accounts payable is actually coming from the Chase vendor here. So what's going to happen when I post this transaction, it's going to mark this voucher to Amazon paid, and then you'll see that it creates a subsequent voucher to Chase. So we'll do just that. We have our $1,000 invoice. I hit post. All right, so let's take a look at our vendor here, Amazon. We'll take a look at there's our $1,000 voucher. You see the unapplied amount is zero, so it has been fully applied. And if you scroll on here a little bit further, you see I have a $1,000 payment transaction. And so here you have it. So I have my Amazon vendor here, and it's denoting that I have a $1,000 payment via credit card with my Kyle Visa Chase credit card. So as far as Amazon is concerned, they are done, they are processed, they are paid in the system. So I'll select OK here. So on the other hand, let's go take a look at Chase. So you recall when we set up the actual credit card at the beginning of this, we selected Chase as the vendor. Well, look here. So now I have a $1,000 voucher, $1,000 unapplied to Chase Bank. All right, so throughout the month, I've added all of my transactions for my credit card processing. And then last thing I would have to do here is either build a batch, or I'm just going to do this quickly. Let's go ahead and do Chase. We'll do a $1,000 payment. And I can just select my vouchers, post. Now I pay my credit card bill. So let's look at a second option. I mentioned with 2018, you get a few additional options in the system. So we just paid one transaction, and as we were entering in that voucher for Amazon, we denoted at that time that it was already paid via credit card. Well, so what happens if we've actually entered the vouchers already in the system, and then at the end of the month, we're like, oh wait, we paid this one with credit card, we paid this one with credit card, etc. Or if we just want to put in all of our vouchers and then just denote that all of them were paid via credit card at the same time. Well, with 2018, you now have that ability to basically build a batch, select credit cards as a payment option, and then select all of your vouchers. So I'm going to start with build payment batch. Let's do monthly credit card. I'm going to go ahead and select credit card as my payment option. My card name, Kyle Visa Chase. And then here, I'm actually just going to pick up everything in the system. So I'm going to put in no filters. That's going to select everything by default. You wave your magic wand. There it is. I've selected every outstanding voucher in the system. I go to edit payment batch. You'll see that all of the outstanding vouchers that are not EFT are the ones that weren't selected here. The ones that are not EFT selected automatically. So in many situations, I wouldn't want to just select them all. So I'm gonna go ahead and peel back a few. I'll just say I'm paying the rest of my Amazon vouchers with credit card. Process my batch here. And now that I've denoted the invoices being paid by credit card, as you would imagine, if I go back and I take a look at Amazon, Amazon here is paid. And then if I look at Chase, Chase now has some new unapplied vouchers. So that's it. Everyone, I appreciate you sticking with me today. That is processing credit cards within Dynamics GP 2018. Talking about a little bit of the new features there. Stay tuned for future posts. Please subscribe. Take a look at us on Facebook. Check out the website. And if you like, give me a shout on LinkedIn. Thanks.